Yes, President Biden, meanwhile, sends an unofficial delegation to Taiwan to signal his personal commitment to the Chinese-claimed island and its democracy. A former U.S. senator and two former deputy secretaries of state were set to meet with senior Taiwanese officials. This is Washington's latest move to affirm relations with Taipei amid increased military activity by China around the self-ruled island. The U.S. State Department earlier said it was issuing new guidelines to enable U.S. officials to meet freely with Taiwan officials. The U.S. is required by law to provide the island with all means necessary to defend itself. But China is not backing down. It warned the U.S. to stop playing with fire over Taiwan and lodged a complaint after the issuance of those guidelines. The Philippines summons China's ambassador to reiterate its demand for Beijing to ensure the immediate departure of its vessels in the West Philippine Sea. Willard Cheng has the details.
Chinese Ambassador Huang Silian was summoned by Manila's Foreign Affairs Department Monday, where the Philippines expressed its displeasure over the illegal lingering presence of Chinese vessels in Julian Felipe Reef. DFA Acting Undersecretary Elizabeth Buensuceso told Ambassador Huang the reef is inside the Philippine Exclusive Economic Zone and the continuing presence of Chinese vessels is a source of regional tension. The DFA invoked the 2016 arbitral ruling that invalidated China's expansive claims over the South China Sea. The Chinese side was also reminded to observe proper decorum and manners as guests of the Philippines. This after the Chinese embassy spokesperson responded to the call of Manila's Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana on China to leave the reef as irresponsible, a demand which the DFA reiterated to Ambassador Huang. Both sides vowed to use peaceful means to address differences over maritime issues. Manila's Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. says only 9 Chinese ships are left in the area based on information from the National Task Force for the West Philippine Sea. Loxin added, it is time for Chinese vessels to leave, underscoring that fishing is not equivalent to a claim of ownership. Loxin called the issue a distraction from the benefits that the country and the region may derive from the good relations of the Philippines and China under the Duterte administration. An analyst believes China will eventually leave the area, but the Philippines has to show that it is serious in protecting its rights by conducting consistent maritime patrols and surveillance and carrying out activities under the Visiting Forces Agreement with the United States.
For now, China may pull out. But I think going forward, it's important to look at, you know, the government's strategic communications. It has to be coherent. At the same time, it has to be properly coordinated with ground actions such.
The Chinese embassy has yet to respond to the DFA statement. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.